Jordan-Hare Stadium. This is what is called by the Tiger football team the Tiger Walk. There are paws that are painted on the streets, and the fans now have spilled over the curbs and onto the street as they want to touch their heroes and wish them well in tonight's matchup against arch rival Tennessee.
The big hit. To win the SEC.
Tennessee Volunteers, ranked number 5 in the nation, come calling against the Auburn Tigers, ranked number 3 in the country. Hello, everybody. I'm Ron Franklin, and welcome once again to ESPN's continuing coverage of CFA football in prime time. What a rivalry and matchup we have here for you this evening. In fact, one of the great rivalries, not only in the Southeastern Conference, but in the entire country. Now, for some of you who live outside of the Southeast, you might be saying, oh, wait a minute, I thought Auburn and Alabama were the big rivalries there. Well, they are. But probably the thing that separates the Southeastern Conference from any other conference in the country is so many great and storied rivalries. This is just one of them. And they come into this ballgame tonight, number 3 against number 5. This is normally the table setter. It is played early in the year. It gives everybody an indication of what the conference race is going to be like. Gary Danielson is standing by at a little bit calmer place and talks about some of the keys of tonight's ball game.
Ron, I'm in the calm serenity of the Auburn weight room to emphasize the point that tonight it's not necessarily going to be trick formations or horizontal and vertical passing game stretches or fancy formations that's going to tip the balance of this football game. Now, that's not to say we don't have plenty of skilled players. Wide receivers, running backs, quarterbacks, defensive backs, as good as anybody has in the country. But tonight, I want you to focus on those offense and defensive linemen. You know, the guys that would rather spend their summer chasing these 400-pound bench presses instead of a golf ball or shooting hoops like us so-called skilled athletes. These are the guys that help make this the number 3 and 5 teams in the country. Look at Tennessee. They've got a huge offensive line. Two tackles, Charles McCray and Antone Davis, both 300 pounds, and both helped gouge this Auburn defense for 350 yards rushing last year. Auburn, they've got some players also. On offense, Ed King. Sports Illustrated said that this guy's going to be an all-pro in the NFL during the 90s, and he's only a junior. And on defense, Lombardi and Outland candidate David Rocker, as good as anybody that's ever played here. Really, though, that's only half the story. The other half of the story? Well, I really don't have to tell you that, because just look for yourself and listen for yourself. They've got 85,000 Tiger fans that are going to be the best 12th man in home field advantage in college football today.
Tonight's game between Auburn and Tennessee brought to you by Sony, bringing people the most entertaining ways to entertain themselves. By Truck Guard from Shell. Think any oil can take care of your truck? And by Koppenheimer, America's number one value clothier for men. 5,214 natural turf, and they have been rocking and rolling like this since about an hour and a half ago. As you look at the head man, Johnny Majors, in his 14th year at the University of Tennessee, 23 years overall as a head coach. The white headgears with the big orange tee from Knoxville. And on the other side of the field, his alma mater is Georgia, played college football there, but in his 10th year with the Auburn Tigers, Pat Dye. paces the sideline in his customary Auburn baseball cap. Joey Chapman has the ball teed at the 35-yard line as you look. The first meeting way back in 1900, 22-17-2. Auburn leading the series in the state of Alabama. The home field advantage, as you can see, has been huge, with Auburn having won 15 of them. Deep in the end zone, Auburn will scrimmage from their own 20-yard line. So now let's take a look at the diehard starting lineups. Offensively, the freshman Stan White out of Birmingham, Alabama. He will have behind him Tony Richardson, a true freshman, and the veteran James Joseph. The wide receivers Greg Taylor and Shane Wasden. The tight end is Victor Hall. Bob Meeks is the center. Ed King, the all-everything left guard, Tim Tillman on the other side, and the tackles, Chris Gray and Rob Selby. Pass on the first play, throws it complete to Victor Hall, but he will be only back to the line of scrimmage. Let's check the starters on defense for Tennessee. Casey Rogers and Chuck Smith at the defensive ends. The tackles, Mark Moore and Kerry Bailey. In the middle of linebacker, not big but active, Sean Walker. On the outside, Daryl Hardy, the veteran, and Ernest Fields. In the secondary, it's Jeremy Lincoln and Floyd Miley. And the safeties, Mark Fletcher and Dale Carter. Auburn throws in first down. They pick up no yardage. White with an audible. Has this one. Complete is Greg Taylor, the intended receiver. And Gary, he looked away just as the ball got there.
No doubt it. Stan put it right on the money right there. They're using the bear defense. Pat Dye told us he expected it. They practiced against it. They worked on it. They're ready to audible. This will not be trying to knock heads all night with trying to run the ball against an eight-man defense. They're going to put it in the air. He says, we have to throw it 50 times. We throw it 50 times. Great confidence in Stan White.
Stan only a freshman, and he will see a lot of looks early from this Tennessee defense. He needs the 30. Set screen, incomplete. Shane Wasden, the intended receiver. And a youngster possibly with a couple of butterflies early on.
He also had somebody in his face. The defensive end was right in his hands up, and he had to throw it a little off target, make sure he didn't get it batted. That's what happens sometimes. Good defense, they're pressuring him early.
Remember last year, the nemesis for the Tigers up in Knoxville. They allowed two safeties on punt miscues. Richie Nell, the punter. Dale Carter is the deep man. Short line drive kick, and Carter should wind up with good return on this one, and he does. Inside the 50 and down to the 47-yard line. It's only a 34-yard punt and five on the return. So let's look at Tennessee offensively. Andy Kelly out of Dayton will start at quarterback. He will have behind him Tony Thompson and Roland Poles. The wide receivers, Anthony Morgan and Alvin Harper. The tight end, Vaughn Reeves. The center, John Fisher. This is a great offensive line. Tom Myslinski and Doug Baird are the guards. And the tackles, Charles McRae and Anton Davis. Play action by Kelly. Throws it complete to the far side of the field, and it will be enough for the Tennessee first down at the 35-yard line as we look at the Auburn defenders. Richard Shea is the nose guard. The two defensive tackles, David Rocker, gets a lot of attention. Don't forget Lamar Rogers. He's a good one. Inside backers, Kerrigan Cunningham and Darryl Crawford. On the outside, it's Ricky Sutton and Benny Pierce. The corners are Ramsey and Barlow, and the safeties, Wiley and Wallace. Tony Thompson fumbles the ball, and Auburn has recovered at the 25. Shea John Wiley makes the recovery. And Gary, Auburn having given up the good field position, what a huge break.
They had to have something like this. There's no doubt that Thompson's going to run the ball back to the weak side of this formation all night. Auburn is playing their defensive secondary to field. That's going to be the game plan. Run back to the tight end behind that huge offensive line. Cunningham with the hit. Wiley with the fumble recovery.
James Joseph, as on this series, Auburn comes out with the ball on the ground. He will go for 1, maybe 2 yards. He's the senior from Phenix City, part of the glue and heart, says his head coach of this offensive unit, has rushed 22 times for 119 yards and 2 touchdowns in the early season.
A little different football. Both teams trying to get their quarterbacks off the mark early, loosen it up, throw the ball. They're both coaches said they're going to take balance is what they're looking for tonight.
White, tip, intercepted. And Gary, in watching that timing pattern, he was late on the delivery, and I think the youngster definitely is suffering the crowd right now.
Well, no doubt. We watched him practice. When you're on the field, this freshman, you really can't take your eyes off him on the practice field. He throws ball after ball. He's got great feet, but you can't throw the ball to the outside late, and that's what he's done here. Good thing he threw a high ball, because that had a potential of being picked off right there.
Miley had broken extremely well in the ball. He probably is one of the best cover men in that Tennessee secondary. Junior from Fort Lauderdale. Third down, Auburn. They need just across their own 35-yard line. Whistles. Flag comes down. Some pushing in the interior line, but that was after the whistle and the flag.
I don't believe is going to put Stan in any big problems right here early in the game. Yes, he believes it and thinks he's got a great arm, and Stan's going to come through and do fine tonight, he believes, but not third and 15 early in a game in his own, backed up in his own zone. I look for a draw, maybe a safe screen pass, something that they want to take the pressure off the young guy.
Sets the screen, that's Joseph. The blockers in front, and he will take it out. Not enough for the first down as he crosses the 31 to the 32-yard line. Going to be good for 12, and Mark Fletcher, the strong safety, is there to make the stop. And the Volunteers with another stop as far as the series.
Tennessee just dropping in zone. Actually, both coaches real happy with that outcome. Auburn wanted to pick up 7 or 8 yards to help with field position. Tennessee, anything but a first down.
Kick good for 34. Now this is a good coverage kick here. Carter signals for the fair catch and executes it at the Volunteer 27. 39 yards in the kick. Just over 12 to play opening period. Nobody on the board as yet. Versus Auburn is brought to you by Jeep. There's only one Jeep. And by Howard Johnson. Where are you going this fall? Go anywhere and get it on the fall sale at Howard Johnson Coast to Coast. Well, what you're looking at is a live picture. The nickname is Tigers, but the battle cry is War Eagle, and that is War Eagle number 6. He's a Golden Eagle mascot, and his nickname, why not? Tiger. Tennessee on offense for the second time tonight. Tony Thompson, left side as a flag is down, and he squirts through a big hole behind McRae and Myslinski. Out to the 37-yard line, Wiley had to come up from the free safety spot. Now, let's check the flag. Pat Dye has to be thinking on the near sideline with that signal of offsides against the Tigers that they have had a delay of game penalty, and now this. Small mental errors that he doesn't want creeping in at any time, but particularly in a big ball game like this early.
One of the problems of playing at home is just sometimes you just get a little bit too jacked up. I mean, you got the whole crowd, you've been thinking about this game for 2 weeks. They had an off game, you got the crowd around, and you're fired up. You just got to go back and do your basics and relax and play football.
Going to go long, looking for Harper, and that one is all it is at the 16 by Corey Barlow.
where Kelly threw this one deep to Harper, and it was a post route, but late on the throw, watch Harper change his mind after Kelly throws the ball. Harper could have ran the post, but the only guy running the post is Barlow. And I don't know if he caught that one or not. Let's see what a little closer look here. Well, you really can't tell that he didn't, so we're not going to overturn it. And I really don't know what the penalty after the whistle again. So even though they get the interception, they're backed up to their 11-yard line.
They have called illegal procedure against Auburn and have pushed the ball back to the 11-yard line. Too much celebration after the play was the procedure call.
There you see that bare front again. Eight-man front.
Stan White lots this one. Complete and very nearly intercepted. Shane Washington again was the intended receiver. Shane Jr. from Selma. Carter and Jeremy Lincoln had that one covered well.
Stan has to be careful. You can't throw a post with the free safety in the center of the field. He has eight men up, but they're still keeping Carter free in the middle to funnel everything towards him. That was a very bad read. He's lucky to get away with that one again.
11:41 left in this opening period. Everybody trying to settle down and settle in on a game that has been talked about since last January the 2nd, I guess. Draw play, Joseph, and he will get nothing. In fact, hardly back to the line of scrimmage as Tennessee was right there. Casey Rogers, the junior from Humboldt, 99, was the first man to make the stop.
Read that very quickly, kind of a draw action, came off and made the nice play.
So it's third down, and for Auburn to maintain possession of the football, they've got to go all the way out to the 27. What kind of call are you looking for here, Dave?
I don't think he's going to chance anything again. Something safe. Look for another draw, quick screen, or something very deep, maybe.
Tony Richardson, the true freshman fullback out of Daleville, Alabama, checks into the ball game. White is hit and is sacked at the 2-yard line as Chuck Smith comes knifing in from that right side. That's a loss of 8. And now Auburn will have to punt, and they do not have the advantage of a full 15-yard drop.
On the left side of your screen, it's Chris Gray, number 68, a converted tight end last year who gets beat on the inside by Smith. Watch him come out, and he overruns it. The inside, you never let him go inside on that blind side of the quarterback.
About a 12-yard drop, and that ball either was partially blocked or off the side of his foot. Is bounding at the 25-yard line. No score, but Tennessee with great field position. We'll be right back.
Number 13, and as Nell hits it, he feels him. Even if it isn't blocked, he feels that pressure from the outside. Either got a little hand on it or he shanked it for a very, very short punt. Of course, Pat Dye is going to get to say, what happened? Did you angle the wrong way? Maybe he was supposed to kick a little bit more to the left.
Well, the point that we have made also, that he did not have a full 15-yard drop. He was only about 12 yards because the ball was snapped from the 12-yard line. Or from the 2, I should say. Tony Thompson down to the 20-yard line of Auburn, and they'll spot him just inside that area. Tony is only 5'7", 181 pounds, but you can tell that on all three carries that he has had tonight, as you look at his average, that's unbelievable, 9.2 in 1990 and 7 touchdowns, that he is very hard to stop at the line of scrimmage and for no gain. They haven't come close so far. Smokey likes it. Thompson again. Flag is down. That's going to be a gain of a couple. Cunningham, 47, one of the first men there to make contact along with John Wilson.
I think Tom Myslinski jumped off a little bit ahead of the snap count that time.
An illegal motion on the offense. A man moving at the snap. He'll be second down.
So both football teams encumbered with some little mistakes early.
Well, I don't, you know, 85,000, big, huge game, 3-5. I mean, these players know the importance of the game, and they are absolutely wired looking at these guys, and they got to just calm down now. Play football. You got a great football team. Play football now.
Blitz from the outside by Auburn. Pass is thrown complete, but only at the 18-yard line. And that's going to be to Carl Pickens, the all-purpose player for Tennessee. He played defense some last year besides playing offense. And he said we could even see him tonight on the defensive side.
Yeah, he played defense, and he, how about high jump? 6 feet, 11, 3/4 on the track team. Not a bad athlete to throw. Just throw it anywhere near him, he can grab it. Tell what he was doing here. I think he's throwing this ball to Harper, but he throws it a little wide, and that's why he almost gets it. And of course, Pierce put some a little bit of pressure on him too from the outside, and that might have hurried the throw, but I think it was an option to Harper that he overthrew.
Burke with a 35-yard attempt. Plenty of distance, and Tennessee is on the scoreboard first. Timeout, 9:11 left in the opening period. Volunteers by 3. 8-0. Tennessee goes in top tomorrow, 1 o'clock Eastern time, Major League Baseball. Toronto at Boston. Boston's 2 games up on Toronto in that AL East after today's 7-5 Red Sox victory. Number 20, Joey Chapman. Redshirt freshman from Franklin, Tennessee. As you look at Corey Lewis standing in the middle, number 2. That's Herbert Casey to the near side. Lewis 3 yards deep, and he is signaled by his teammates. Don't bring it out. So again, good job by Chapman to kick it into the Auburn end zone. There is a flag down out at the 23.
Doesn't need to be backed up again. They're just this field position so far has not allowed them to run their offense the way they want to.
After the play was over, we had offsetting personal fouls against both teams. The two players have been ejected.
Both players have been ejected.
One of the things that Pat Sullivan said about Stan White is we can't ask him to do anything in the fourth quarter that they're not going to let him do in the first quarter. They've got to get him on track. This is a tough defense. They've started their own 19, as you can see. They're a little bit nervous about letting him do everything down there.
Joseph, flag goes down. Takes it out for about 4 yards. Still some pushing and shoving in the secondary. And now let's check the marker at the 21-yard line.
They're as confused as we are right now as to what this one is.
An illegal procedure against the offense. There's only 6 men on the line of scrimmage.
Johnny Majors paces on the far side, but if you think he's pacing, take a look at that guy right there.
Yeah, he's pacing and yelling at the same time.
He is not real happy with the way his football team has started this game. Joseph to the 19. We will continue to check. The referee said the two players were kicked out of the ballgame, but we have just checked with David Housel, sports information director here at Auburn, and the head of officials said no one was kicked out.
Well, I sure heard it. I don't know if they did it. Well, you to see Joseph. He was preseason All-SEC also. Sporting News rated him number third fullback, number three fullback in the country, playing tailback and fullback when they're in the one-back set.
Joseph on the draw. This time a little bit more running room, but that defense of Tennessee closes it up quickly. Mark Moore, the first man there, to put a helmet on him. And now it's going to be third down Auburn, and they need just out across the 30-yard line to pick it up.
Ed King there, left guard, number 67. Watch him drive out and takes his man away. Little hold on the back. Little reputation there. He's not going to get called on that. But this guy is just one powerful blocking left back. Ed King, a junior. Been hearing a lot about him and watching a lot of him now.
We can see White motioning quickly. He's going to have to call a timeout, is he? No. The guard, King, comes up out of his stance. They did get the timeout called with 2 seconds showing on the 25-second clock.
Well, they have not been a piece of uniformity so far. Ed King's got his eye on the clock. He's going to give the freshman a little bit of help. He says, hey, you got to call timeout. Stan White, you're in the wrong formation. Guys, get over here. He's looking at the clock. He's trying to look at the defense. Somebody says, call timeout. Come on, please call timeout. How about the All-Americans going to call timeout? Thanks, Ed. Thanks for making me look bad for everybody.
Herbert Casey, number 20. He's only a sophomore from Foley. And he is the player that White was trying to get to come in motion.
I think he probably lined up wrong, and he lined up on the wrong side of the formation, and they just couldn't run the play with him on that side. He had to move him. I'd like to see him throw the ball deep downfield. You get an interception, you know, 20, 30, 40 yards downfield, it's just as good as a punt, and let it air it out a little bit.
Tigers need six. White, that ball is tipped and it's going to be intercepted. Jeremy Lincoln, number 25, comes up with the pickoff.
Well, Stan White's gotten off to a rough and shaky start so far. Again, he only tried to throw the ball deep. You see it from behind, what he's looking at. Not much pressure so far, but there you see the ball tipped, and it goes right to the defense. Those are the tough ones. You think you got a guy open, he's running it. He probably could have got this picked off anyway, because Jeremy Lincoln beat him the ball through the pass. He ran it all the way.
Thompson on the sweep. He will have a couple, but you can hear the groan from the crowd. And now let's go for an update to Tim Brando.
There's been a lot of talk, Ron Franklin, that Florida State could be looking past Virginia Tech because of Miami, and that Miami could be looking past Iowa. Right now, Virginia Tech has the lead. Will Fuhr, a pair of touchdown passes to John Rivers. Right now, the Hokies have the lead in the second quarter. We'll keep you posted. Let's get back to your ball game, the biggest of the day.
Thanks, Tim. It's been some kind of day like that, hasn't it? Boy, would that ever be huge. 3-0 here. Tennessee leads, and they have had great field position in this first quarter. Thompson again hammers his way behind that big offensive front, this time utilizing Antone Davis and Doug Baird. And Eric Ramsey comes from his left cornerback position to make the play defensively. That's 5 carries for 29 yards so far for Tony Thompson.
Nothing fancy. I don't just honk it up in there behind Davis and Baird. I think that's a good game plan. 310 pounds, just run up north and south. That's what Thompson does best.
Third down. Reverse. And that will be close to the first down as Vince Moore coming back on the quick cutter. Ramsey again had to make the play, and let's see where they're going to spot it down. That is plenty enough for the Tennessee first down as they put it just inside the 15.
Real well-conceived play. You can see on the right side of your screen, they line up Davis and McCray together and then run the reverse away from the Vince Moore. A very good design play. Put both tackles on the left side, then ran the reverse to the right.
Tony Thompson that time goes for short yardage as he is knocked down by Ricky Sutton, also Walter Tate. Walter is is only a sophomore. It's 6'2", 306 pounds. He is from Decatur, Georgia. Five and a half minutes left, opening quarter. Auburn, Alabama, Tennessee 3, Auburn nothing, and the Volunteers driving. Thompson puts a head down to Gary, I'll tell you, for 181 pounds. He doesn't mind taking on the world, does he?
We watched some film on him, and he just runs north and south. He's a very good north-south runner. Of course, with this line, watch him here behind Davis. He comes up right into Rocker. There's the matchup. The two All-Americans, of course, he's getting some help from Mark Adams, the tight end also on Rocker. But when you can just run north-south like that, full head of steam, you're going to gain some positive yards down there. Coaches love guys that run north and south in this plus territory right here.
This is the deepest drive by Tennessee. It is third down. They need the five. Thompson on the draw, going to be hit in the backfield and will be knocked down for the loss as 91 Lamar Rogers stops him for a loss of three.
Rogers comes off the block. Reads the draw well. Watch him on the right side. He gives an arm over, swims, and there he is, right in his face. No place to go for Thompson. That's the way to stop the draw. If you can beat the men up front, they had a good play call. They were all spread out, but just man on man, Rodgers wins.
Greg Burke hit his first attempt tonight. This one coming from 32 yards. And he knocks this one home. So Tennessee, with a couple of early breaks, comes away with two field goals. And it is 6-0, and Volunteers on top.
Ron, things have not gone well for Pat Dye, but I think he's got to feel fortunate only being behind 6-0 right now. They have had great field position, Tennessee, and they just haven't been able to stick it in the end zone.
Well, next week here on ESPN. Day begins at 11:30 with Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Charlene Hawks. Then Lafayette and Columbia at 12:30 Eastern Time. Followed by LSU at Florida. Gary and I will be down in Gainesville, 7:30 Eastern Time, and then immediately followed by Washington State taking on 18th-ranked USC. Hey, what a strange situation today in Columbus, Ohio. USC won.
Called the game.
But rarely do you see football games called because of weather, but not only the rain, but the lightning.
And we saw it. I mean, it looked like if there was ever going to be a reason to call a game, that might be it. It was as bad as you could see. There you see Pat Dye. We had a quick look at the Auburn defense. They've done a good job here now. I mean, they kept it to 6-0. They have to feel satisfied.
This will come down to Herbert Casey at the 10-yard line. Casey breaks it all the way up to the 40. 28 yards on the return by Herbert Casey, and Fletcher saved what was a lot more real estate.
We're going to see the special teams play. That's always big in a tight game. Casey just runs full. What a hole. I could run up that one. Then he gets a little dodge, and then he accelerates through. Last guy back was the kicker there. That's the field position they needed. Now out to the 40-yard line.
He also needed to make amends for his mistake on that play a while ago.
It's a lot more fun coming to the sideline this time than last time.
It was Wasden in motion, and Joseph got tripped up with the line of scrimmage, and he might have had a lot more. You see Hardy in the vicinity, but Corey Bader tripped him up.
I think James Joseph and Tony Thompson remind me a lot of each other in their style they run. Joseph's a bigger version of Thompson, but they both like to run north-south. They trust their line, they hit the holes where they're designed, and they hit it full speed.
Side handoff to the freshman. This is Tony Richardson. He is going to have the first down at the 50-yard line. As a couple of conversations continued after the play, you could see Bob Meeks coming in the block. And now all of a sudden, this Auburn crowd is getting into the ballgame.
There you see the freshman fullback. Can you imagine a guy, a freshman coming out of high school and starting for Auburn, the type of players they've got on this football team? Pat Dye, though, he smiled the whole time he was talking about this guy. Said he just jumped out at us. A great blocker and fullback for him.
Joseph, what a job as Hardy jumps in first. Darrell Hardy, a junior from Cincinnati.
he had a field goal block against Colorado. 22 total tackles on the year, and the coaches say, Larry Lesswell said, the best way to describe him is he's just a very smart football player, very heady.
He led him in tackles last year, too, in 1989. He just gets around the football and effort, dives over the guy to make the play there. I like that.
Best field position of the evening for the Auburn Tigers. White. Asking for a block, and woo, he gets clobbered, but he takes it down to the 40-yard line. Chuck Smith, along with Floyd Miley defensively, and that is very close to another Auburn first down. From here, it would appear he's going to be just a few inches short.
I think he starts to feel good now. You know he's going to get hit. He gets a chance to run. He's going to get in the game. His heart's not pounding anymore. 4-6 speed for this freshman, and he's a big 6'2". He's not a little guy. He looks big, brawny, and he can run.
The head, and there's not much there, as he'll be stopped by Chuck Smith. Ernest Fields, you also saw number 23 get off the stack. Ernest is a junior from Milan, Tennessee. 1:35 left in his opening quarter. Auburn, Alabama, 6-0. Tennessee on top. And I mentioned the fact that the Auburn crowd is finally into this one because of field position and mistakes. They simply haven't been able to be.
They just had to hold on for now. Now they got some field to runs and plays.
White again freezes him with the play action, throws incomplete at the 27. And very quickly, let's go back to Tim Brando. Timmy.
The cheer in Blacksburg, Virginia. Hokey, hokey, hokey high. We're the boys from VPI. It's 21-3 Virginia Tech. Tony Kennedy, a 26-yard run for a touchdown. The number 2 Seminoles down by 18. I know it's early. This, though, is news. Back to Ron.
Yeah, you've got that one on the head, Tim. 21-3 over the second-ranked team in the nation.
This, if that holds up, that will be a big, big game.
Stacy Dadley has come in as the lone setback, number 32. Incomplete. Greg Taylor is who he wanted. They were trying to throw on rhythm, but in Stan White's defense, he had a Tennessee defender in his face, Casey Rogers.
Greg Taylor is just going to run about a 6-yard out right here. Timing is the word that you have to have. He turns, he looks for the ball. It should be on its way. There's not a lot of time to react to one of those. It has to be a good throw, and Stan didn't put it on the money. You're not going to complete. They're giving him the catch. He's just got to throw it to him.
Tennessee sit there and wait on that one. Floyd Miley came up from that quarterback position, and then he had a lot of help from a lot of friends. 87, Daryl Hardy, along with Kerry Bailey. And Auburn will have to punt it away after moving the ball for the first time across midfield. Richie Nell. This is an area of the Auburn football team that Coach Dye said he was concerned with. Very high, good coverage kick. Fumble, and Carter will make the recovery at the 16. Oh, wow. 20 yards and a kick, but he did his job that time. Really good coverage kick.
Well, he put it up high, put it in the middle of the field, and Carter did the right thing by calling the fair catch, because if it hits down on the field, it could roll anywhere, but you got to catch the ball.
Wayne Hall, the defensive coordinator for Auburn, said the thing that they feared most, the big play of the Tennessee Volunteers, as you get one more look at Carter's muffing the ball, and nothing but blue around him. But this is a part of the field that he's talking about. And this is where Tennessee burned them last year. It's Thompson going to be wrapped up after a gain of only a couple on the play is Dennis Wallace, one of the first men with Anthony Judge combining on the tackle.
Auburn will substitute. They'll play a lot of players. Anthony Judge, a backup, is in there. James is in there. Willis is in there. They're going to play their backups, keep them fresh. The long football game in Auburn, the tradition Pat Dye learned it in Alabama. They're going to keep their players in there and keep them fresh.
Play action. near sideline, has it complete again. Alvin Harper pushed out of bounds. He's shy of the 30, but it's still enough for the Tennessee first down. And with that, the end of the first period with our score, Tennessee 6 and Auburn nothing. Why Oldsmobile. Step into the future now with your Oldsmobile dealer. And by Dun & Bradstreet Software. State-of-the-art software and service worthy of it. Ron Franklin and Gary Danielson in Auburn, Alabama, 6-0. Tennessee, ranked number 5 in the nation, leading over number 3 ranked Auburn. Boy, the turnovers for the Volunteers in the early going to this one. Plus 11 turnover ratio in the first 4 games, and tonight a minus 2, 3 intercepts and 1 fumble. But Tennessee still holds on as they lead 6-0. Thompson, there is nothing there as he will be knocked out as he tries to regain the line of scrimmage. First man to come across was Walter Tate, number 76. You see that American flag on the back of the Auburn headgears. We were told before the ball game that that will be a permanent part of the uniform, that that is for the hostages in Iraq and also Kuwait. And they have yellow ribbons down in the goalposts in both end zones. They will stay there until those people are released. Fake the pitch, got him to bite on it, and Kelly can't get the shoulder squared. It's incomplete. Once again, let's go to Tim Brando.
Florida State's making a move, though it is halftime, and they trail 21-18. Amp Lee had a 5-yard touchdown rushing. Brad Johnson to Shannon Baker, a 4-yard pass. And then Johnson takes it in for the 2-point conversion. So Bobby Bowden's club down by only 3 at the intermission in Tallahassee. Let's get back to your game and to Ron and Gary.
Jim, something tells me that if someone had told all of us that 39 points would be scored in the first half, you probably would think a very lopsided first half for the Seminoles. But it hasn't been the case. Third down for the Volunteers. Kelly gets it away and has it complete to Alvin Harper. Cuts it back at the 20, and he'll score. 82 yards. Wayne Hall said, and I mentioned earlier, we can't give up the big play. This is a 3rd and 10, which is almost inexcusable, isn't it?
He puts the ball over the head just in a perfect trajectory where only Harper can catch the ball. Once he gets into the open field, this guy's a track guy. I mean, he can run and run. He uses the referee. He cuts back and takes it all the way. That's a heartbreaker. 3rd and 10 to get that type of a play.
Alvin Harper, and you talked about the ability of Pickens, almost a 7-foot high jumper. Harper has high jumped over 7 feet. We'll talk more about that as Tennessee was lining up to go for 2, and Johnny Major says, I want Kelly here on the sideline to talk about it. So there's a timeout with 7:49 left until halftime.
And Kelly's got a little rocky start. He's got 3 interceptions, but that one's going to make the stats look a little better and make him breathe a little easier. And this is the right move by Johnny Majors. Those timeouts are not as important in the first half as they are in the second half. Make sure this is a big points right here. Get a couple points and take that to 14-0, and that's those 2 field goals turn into a touchdown real quick. Corey Barlow went for the interception. The ball just seemed to hang and go a little farther than he thought, and all of a sudden Harper has it. He's in the open field.
Well, we talked about the poise of Kelly, and Kelly was being hit as he got the ball away. But you're right. Would Barlow bid on it on a 3rd and 10?
Well, you know, when I saw him throw the ball, I thought he threw it a little off balance myself, and the ball just made it far enough. I think Barlow said, well, I'm going to be able to get it. I mean, he's a preseason All-SC player. He's got plenty of experience, and he cut underneath for the interception, and all of a sudden it turns into a touchdown.
12-0, Tennessee, and the Volunteers will go for 2. Well, the officials stopped it momentarily to talk over something. Now it's whistled back in as Gerald Crawford comes back into the lineup defensively for Auburn. Hit is Amsler, and he will be dropped for a loss. So now there was a timeout. Tennessee 12 and Auburn nothing.
Out there, Barlow tries to break inside of it, but Morgan has it. It's Harper has it. He cuts back, and there he goes. Look at those long strides. He looks, he sets him up. He knows he's going to cut. Cuts back, turns him, and just runs away from him again. 82 yards, longest touchdown pass for Kelly and for Harper. Here you go, Kelly. This turns a three-interception night. Yeah, give it to him. One more time. Go to the bench, get some Gatorade, and have some fun.
By the way, that's the longest touchdown pass for Andy Kelly, and also the longest touchdown reception by Alvin Harper of Tennessee. Going to be a short kick. This one is going to take a bounce, and Pedro Cherry will take the ball down at the 17-yard line. And now let's go back to Tim Brando. Tim.
California and Arizona, Russell White, always the story for the boys from Berkeley, Ryan. Watch him here against Arizona. This has always been a topsy-turvy series, by the way. This could be the third straight upset if the Golden Bears get it done. White, 39 yards on the catch from Pulaski, and it's now 28-13, California. Let's get back to number 3 versus number 5.
California looked good in that opening game against Wisconsin and gave Miami trouble for a goodly part of that ball game. White has it complete. That's Fred Baxter, the tight end, sophomore from Brundage. Good for 14 yards. Fletcher made the stick.
That's what White has to do, is just relax, throw the ball. He's got a great arm. The ball just rockets out of his hand when you watch it. It's in his hand, it's out of his hand. Before, no wasted motion. And he hits Baxter right in the face. Throwing it in the deep zone that Tennessee's given a little bit. Let's see if they come back to that 8-man up. So far, White's 4-for-11 now with one interception.
Williams hit in the backfield, and he will be knocked down for no gain. Well, Tennessee defensively is Todd Kelly, who is backing up Chuck Smith, a sophomore from Hampton, Virginia.
Watch Kelly come in here from the right side of your screen. He just comes in from the left side of your screen and just grabs and throws him back. Yeah, right on your head. Make the tackle and make it emphatically. Let him know. Get on TV. Turn around. Put the hands up.
12-0. Volunteers lead. Just under 7 to play until halftime. White over the middle. That's Joseph. Hit from behind. Recovered by Tennessee, and that is returnable because it's beyond the line of scrimmage. And down at the 6-yard line. Todd Kelly is the man who made the hit. Lewis picked it up and headed for the end zone. You'll see it again.
Nice safe throw. Hits it to Joseph. He gets hit from behind, and out goes the ball. Boom, it's flying. Lewis picks it up. Looks like he's going to score here. White is the only one that can turn him back in. He turns him back, and he bumps, and he runs. Looks like he's going to go down, and he's getting pushed from behind. Ends up on the 5-yard line. And Tennessee's pretty tough from the 5-yard line in.
Amsler straight ahead, hurdles down to the 3-yard line. Tennessee, like lightning. Boy, Kelly came into the ball game, and look at this. Tennessee inside the 5, 29 rushing TDs in their last 32 possessions. Does that say something about that really fine offensive line?
I think really it makes big this, and yeah. Fine offensive line.
Fisher, Myslinski, Baird, Anton Davis, and Charles McCray. Again, and he'll score.
Amsler is a very valuable backup fullback. That's a good receiver, but he comes in these short yardage situations, really could turn it up. 230 pounds, and he's valuable on that goal line offense. He just turned up the corner. It almost looks like a guard running up in there.
Greg Burke tries to put the Volunteers on top, 19 to nothing.
Goal line situation from the end zone. You're playing linebacker. Once he gets his shoulders turned up, he can just power it into the end zone.
So far, it has been all Volunteers. 19 to nothing. Not many people walk into Jordan-Hare Stadium and have their own way, but that has been the situation so far. And the battle in the trenches so far belongs to the Volunteers of Tennessee.
And it kind of looks how the scoreboard does, too. Also, the turnovers. I mean, that's been the Joseph's had two big fumbles. That one from behind on a first down throw where he could have just fallen over the first down was a huge one.
Corey Lewis from the nine. Gets around the corner, but he steps out of bounds close to the 25. Dave Thomas defensively is there to make the stop on the special teams. And it goes without saying for the Auburn Tigers, they need something out of this drive, point production wise.
Well, if there was ever a time for Stan White to get hot, I mean, they've got to open the game up for him now. He's got great tools. He's got to step back, throw the ball. He's seeing a lot of different defenses. Larry Lacewell said he was going to take it tough on him, and he has so far with a lot of different looks.
Over the middle has Joseph at the 30-yard line. That'll be a gain of close to five on the play. Hardy, one of the first Volunteers there to make the tackle.
Went right back to the guy who fumbled on the play before. Same play, a little play-action pass. Dump it off to the back who's checking down over the middle. Tennessee now playing a little different style. Setting back in the zone, but they got a turnover with it last time. So it's working for them.
Short of the first down by about a yard and a half. Ernest Fields was the first guy there.
Nothing's been easy for Auburn, though. I mean, every play is they just get as much as they can out of it. They haven't been able to break one into the secondary. No guy running free, catching the ball and running. That's the sign of great defense by Tennessee. They're all pursuing to the ball.
4 minutes, 30 seconds left until halftime. He's going to have the first down at the 36, but Dotson made him pay for it. Dwayne, a sophomore from Hendersonville.
Tigers were fortunate again that time. King pulled around on a short yardage play and overran Dotson. You can't do that on a short yardage play. Watch King. He comes around, pulling around, and he misses the backer. Overruns the backer. And all of a sudden, he's right in the ball carrier. That's what causes the fumbles. You expect that guard to be there.
White hand is hit and it is tipped away at the 42. White got the pass away, but just as he did, he was being hit by Mims.
Chris Mims came around, 6'6", 230. You'll see him come from the left side. He's coming around. Stan sets up, but he's just got to free run him, and he gets pushed from the back by Selby. But that's all he had to do is get his arm up, because that's the direction that White was throwing the ball. I don't blame you, Chris. I'd be happy, too. They're all over the quarterback.
Has a man, and wide open and complete is Dale Overton across midfield at the Tennessee 48-yard line as Fletcher came over to make the hit on him. Well, Auburn had gone just over 5 minutes without picking up a first down, and now they put back-to-back first downs together, and that's good for 15. Tennessee 19, Auburn nothing, as we have 3:50 to play till halftime. Half time, we'll be going to Tim Brando to update you on today's action and also some possible upsets that are happening tonight. Williams with the pitch. Orange all around, squirts through a couple of the tacklers, and he'll take it to the 46. Dotson the first man, and then you see Hardy.
They're just playing such great defense right now. Tennessee running, pushing their hands down. Trider guys are trying to get to their feet. They push them and they run. They push them and they run. And what they're doing a great job of is tackling. A guy catches the ball. If he's got a chance in the defensive secondary, he's making the tackle. They're not getting those extra yards. Nothing's happening. They gain 5 yards. They don't get anything else but 5 yards. They're not making the big miss and making the big play so far.
Joseph is the only setback for Auburn.
Eight man up. What's he going to do?
Blitz coming right up the middle. Pass near sideline to Overton, caught it out of bounds.
Stan is just late with the ball all night so far. He had the right audible call. He read the blitz, but he just hasn't been getting the ball out of his hand in the proper rhythm. He just has to relax. He knows what he's doing. It's just a little tougher in front of 85,000 people in the SEC than it is on the practice field. Watch, just a little bit late. When he hits that fifth-foot step right there, he's got to let the ball go. He hit the fifth, and he kind of took a couple more baby steps. Too late to throw the ball.
6 of 15, one interception for 47 yards for White so far.
We got too many guys out there.
Taylor came on off the field. To Wisden inside the 30-yard line.
Well, it was almost an illegal substitution. I mean, the guy came on late. They went to a widespread offense to an I formation play action. Almost, I mean, it really crossed up Tennessee, and that's how they got the guy over the middle open so much. They went from a one back to a two back. The guy goes in motion, and suddenly he's on the bench. There you see him. He comes. He gets pushed in. That's the way he wanted to go anyway. Throws it on the mutton right there. Shane Wasden, high school quarterback.
White, in and out of the hands of Overton, and he had the ball deflected at the last moment by Lincoln. And a flag is down. That's going to be offensive holding against the Auburn Tigers.
I think Wayne Gandy got a little bit of a holding right there to the blind side of the quarterback because Stan was throwing to his right again, and they'll back him up. The rhythm of the Auburn passing game just isn't there. Either the receivers aren't going deep.
And holding by the offense on the play, we steal first down and 20.
Either the receivers aren't going deep enough or Stan's just waiting a little bit longer. Let's watch it. See if we can see any holding up front. He's got somebody. He pushes up. I don't think who that was the call. And I think it was Wayne Gandy on the left side of the screen that we couldn't just quite see. Of course, those guys on the left side of the quarterback, you know, when they make a mistake, the quarterback goes down. So holding isn't the worst call all the time you can have. Another kind of, they always seem to be a little bit confused tonight in their formations.
White tip and caught. That's Chariot, the incomplete. Now they're going to say he trapped it after the tip ball. Boy, in a tip in that area, that's interception time again, isn't it?
Stan misread at that time. He had a free man in the middle of the field, and he thought he had man coverage. There they see him dropping in the zone. And there's a guy standing there reading his eyes. He breaks before he throws it, and he could have got the big interception. Tip, tip. Cherry would have made a nice catch, but it wasn't that difficult. Just all of a sudden, there it is. Two guys tip it. Cherry.
Ernest Fields was the last guy, though. Under pressure, gets it away, and complete at the 18-yard line. Greg Taylor.
Well, it's going to be on his shoulders all night. Taylor's going to have to come through. Waston's going to have to come through. Little play action pass. He gets turned around. He gets pressure. Lets this one go. That's no fun. But he gets it just far enough. There you see everybody converge on it. But Taylor protects the ball very nicely right then. Puts his back into the secondary and makes the catch.
Taylor is from nearby Opelika, which is right next door to Auburn. Rolls it, complete, and the freshman, Tony Richardson, He has to put out a supreme effort just to get back to the line of scrimmage because of Darrell Hardy.
I think that's the key. Hardy knocked him, jostled him a little bit, and then he comes out into the flat and doesn't have any depth. He completes a pass for no yards. He should be out there 2 to 3 yards deep.
Clock is now under a minute and a half as it runs with 122, 121. Darrell Williams comes into the backfield. Williams hit at the line of scrimmage. In fact, he's going to be stopped for a loss at Kerry Bailey again for Tennessee. Also, Mark Moore, you see Big 74, the senior from Charleston, West Virginia. And a timeout is called to stop the clock with 60 seconds left until halftime.
Draw right here off the I formation. No place to go. They're just defeating the blocks up front.
So let's take a quick break. Tennessee 19-0. Halftime and the situation for the Auburn Tigers. They have the ball just outside the Tennessee 18-yard line. It is third down. And they need about 11 yards to pick up the first.
I know as a quarterback, of course, nobody likes third and 25 or anything, but third and 11 in this field position is very, very difficult to throw the ball. If they play a zone, they won't be backing up very far. They're all going to break on the ball. A smart defense for Tennessee. I mean, they're either going to come at them all, but I think they're going to sit back in the zone and try to play it in front of them, come back and hit them, and give up the field goal if they have to. Tennessee secondary has just been playing outstanding. Tackling well, disguising the coverage as well, coming up, batting some balls down, reading Stan White's eyes. Everything is fit together so far in the secondary.
And the other group that needs attention is the pressure by the inside people has made them look even better.
No doubt. It always has a tendency to work.
Tennessee coming with the two backers in the middle, also from the outside, and it is caught out of bounds. Taylor had it, trying to keep his feet in bounds, and he couldn't.
Kind of a gamble call. They brought seven people, so it's man-to-man out there, and it's thrown. You can see his toe came down on the line. It was out of bounds. Nice try by Taylor, buddy. You're out of bounds.
Von Weil to attempt a field goal of 36 yards. He's one of three this year, but his longest is 48. Distance on this one, and he splits it. So Auburn on the scoreboard with 51 seconds left until halftime, and it's now 19-3. U.S. Army Student Athlete of the Game is brought to you by the U.S. Army. Learn how to get an edge on life. Be all you can be. Tonight's student of the game is wide receiver Pedro Cherry of the Auburn Tigers. He is a pre-engineering major with a GPA of 3.5. And our congratulations to Pedro Cherry, tonight's student of the game, brought to you by the U.S. Army. Ron Franklin and Gary Danielson in Auburn, Alabama. 19-3, the Tennessee Volunteers. Tennessee 3-0-1 coming into this one tonight. Johnny Majors told us last evening as we visited with him that he thought, yes, it was an advantage that they had played four ball games and Auburn only having played two.
One thing has held up for us all year is the team that's played the most games seems to be a little bit ahead so far in these games. Of course, the home field advantage should balance that, but Auburn has been a little bit nervous, off balance, a little bit not doing the things that they do best. Of course, you know, you play against a guy like Larry Lacewell, the defensive coordinator for Tennessee. He's seen it all, been through it all, and he could put a lot of different looks on Stan White, and it's given him problems tonight.
From the 1 yard line, Carter tries to hurdle a second tackler, and he brings it out to around the 24 yard line. 46 seconds left until halftime. We'll be going back to Timmy B. Talk about what's happening in that Cal and Arizona game. Also, Florida State and VPI have a wild one going tonight. The number two Seminoles were trailing in that one. Had cut it back to 3 points at halftime.
Not too surprising the type of talent on that football team. They're going to score some points. Very, very safe formation. They're just going to take it to halftime. Ball on the ball. Kelly, 6'4", 11, three interceptions, but he had that big touchdown on a throw that Barlow kind of misjudged a little bit. Harper got in the secondary, took it all the way, 82 yards. That'll do something for your confidence. 133 yards and one TD pass. Kelly's never lost as a starter. Johnny Majors talked to us last night and said the guy does all the things that you have to do to win football games. Gets the ball off on time, a great leader, command of the huddle, command of the offense. That's what Tennessee has to have, especially with the type of offensive line they have where they're going to run the ball on anybody.
So it is halftime, and Andy Kelly sprints for the locker room as the Tennessee Volunteers leading at intermission 19-3. I think everybody, along with a mini thousand wearing orange here tonight, are in a state of shock right now.
As am I. I thought that Auburn would play much better. They just seemed to be out of sync so much. I think the defensive fronts and the changeups have caused them plenty of problems. They haven't been able to run the ball, and Stan White hasn't been able to handle the mismatches and the changeups in the secondary. And those are big problems for a young quarterback.
Okay, so it's time to take a break, and if you gentlemen about to come to us at halftime wonder what the agenda here is for the scribes and for the broadcasters, it's War Eagle pie and also roast beef at halftime. But let's go right now to Tim Brando at the studio. The fact that the confusion has been the big factor in the first half as far as Auburn offensively.
They've got a young quarterback. He's going to be a great quarterback. But any quarterback, senior or freshman or a pro quarterback, is going to have problems when he's got people in his face and he's confused. He's starting to tip off his passes by staring down his receivers, and that zone collapses. But that hasn't been the only problem. They haven't been able to run the ball. 24 rushes for 54 yards is not enough help. Here you take a look at the defense. They try to run the zone. The draw play against the zone blocking, and they're just piling it up. Tennessee is tackling so well from the linebackers in the secondary.
So what about the battle of the trenches? Something that we talked about off the top of the telecast tonight. You have to say that the Volunteers, for the most part, have won that.
They have. They've had the big play, but here you go. Look at Antone Davis. He's going to go against All-American and All-American David Rocker here. He pushes him back. And watch the enthusiasm when he gets up here. He knows he's got it in his hands. Right? Yes, I'm doing what I have to do. And that's infectious, and that's what they're doing. They haven't had big yards, but they have had positive yards, and that's what they have to do in this ball game is keep moving the ball with that big offensive line.
Well, here are some interesting numbers also as far as a comparison of stats in the first half between Auburn and Tennessee. Time of possession, Tennessee, 9:56. Auburn has controlled the ball, but the turnovers have been so very big. Let's go very quickly to the statistics, and this is what it shows in the first half of play. Tennessee with only five first downs, 133 yards passing, rushing 48.
And they've been effective pushing into the end zone. A tough day so far for White, but he has to rise to the occasion to get the team moving.
With the chant of War Eagle, the second half underway as Carter will come out close to the 20-yard line. And in this half, particularly to open it up, I would be extremely surprised if you didn't see Auburn really going after the football, because they have got to make something happen. They wrestled the momentum away from Tennessee, maybe you could say at the end of the first quarter, and then the Volunteers came right back and wrapped it up and took it back from them. Crowd trying to become a major part of this one. Thompson, hit at the line of scrimmage. It's going to be second down and 10. Now, not surprising that Lamar Rogers and also Ricky Sutton, number 92, as we see a fired up Auburn defense to open this second half of play.
Look at the intensity. You can see it in their eyes. They just got ripped from the locker room. I guarantee you, they've just been saying, your pride's on the line. This is your home. Get ready to play football.
Fake to Thompson. Kelly rolls the pocket, has a man open, and that is complete to Harper. Nope, they're going to say cut it out of bounds. So now it will be third down. And the tough thing for Tennessee right here is where they are scrimmaging the football, Gary, is right in front of the Auburn student section.
Well, I think the thing I like that's nice about what they've started, they're not closing up their tents and hanging on to the score right now. They're coming up. They have confidence in Kelly. He's throwing the ball. He's got some outstanding wide receivers. And they're not packing it away. They're going to keep attacking. 19-3, they're not satisfied. Keep trying to put the ball, some points on the board.
Third and 10, Tennessee. Kelly, incomplete, and the Vols will have to punt.
Well, it's a good thing Kelly wasn't on target that time, because Dennis Wallace had him zeroed in on that pass, and he was going to lay one at him. How about this? First punt of the game for Tennessee so far.
Joey Chapman, an average of 44 and a half yards per boot. His longest is 74. Freshman from Franklin, Tennessee. Shane Wasdin is the deep man for the Tigers. This is a good high coverage kick. Wasdin fumbles the football but gets on it at the 40-yard line. 41 yards on the punt. So the freshman from Birmingham comes on with a load on his shoulders, with Auburn down by 16 and ranked number 3 in the nation.
He's got a lot of help in that locker room. Pat Sullivan, a guy who played won the Heisman here. There you go again, another late substitution in the huddle right now. A little bit of confusion, a guy's coming off barely. I don't know what they're trying to do.
Williams breaks it for 5, cut it off at close to 10 yards on the carry.
I think it's almost illegal, the type of substitution they're doing real late like that. They got a receiver jogging off the field just prior to the snap, and they catch Tennessee a little bit off balance again with the counter trap up the middle.
This time it's Joseph. He takes it at left tackle, spins off, breaks it open, one man to beat, and he steps out of bounds at the 33. Ernest Fields assisted him out of bounds, but it's a gain of 15.
Watch Joseph. It wasn't really great blocking up front, but they pushed, and they moved their feet, and they pushed. He runs into somebody, but he bounced. He spins, he turns. Now watch him use the referee to get one more block right here on the right side. Yep, good block. That's what you got to do to get outside. Use all 12 of the guys to get outside.
By the way, we got a report at halftime that Sean Walker, the starting linebacker for Tennessee, was one of those players who was ejected on that opening kickoff. Fred Baxter, the sophomore tight end, broke off the line of scrimmage early, and this is right where Auburn started the football game. Little mistakes.
Dead ball foul before the snap. Illegal procedure. Offense. Still first and 15.
The other player who was kicked out, Wayne Bielsma, who's a junior from Opelika.
There you see Stan White. He was a little confused on the snap count. You'd think the quarterback would always know it. That was one of the problems all the time. You have to turn around and ask guys. You're thinking of so many numbers and plays and formations, you forget the snap count yourself.
The middle, it's Joseph down to the 31 of Tennessee.
That really has been their most effective play so far tonight. They use 3 wide receivers, a little play action to Joseph, and after the fake, he checks down and gives him the throw over the middle, and that was about 11-yard gain right there on a play that's just really pitch and catch, and that's also the play that they got the fumble on, that they ran it back to the 5 where he got hit from behind. So Joseph, just hang on to it.
Second down and about 4. Williams cannot turn the corner defensively. Chuck Smith is out there to make the hit. The junior from Athens, Georgia. I'll tell you what, Tennessee has gotten awfully good play out of that position, because Todd Kelly came in to relieve Chuck Smith, and he caused a fumble and made a great open field hit when
they're
he was
They're really
in.
Running. They're bringing the cornerbacks up in the flats, running too deep in their corners up. All of a sudden, you see as a running back that corner in your face, and you're getting turned back into that pursuit, and the pursuit has been there. There's no place for the running back to cut back. Third and about five.
And the Tigers, 2 of 10 on third down conversions tonight. Joseph. The crowd tells you he has the first down and about five more.
Joseph takes this one running full speed, James gets it. Watch this. He's got some room to really go. He's got it, and he's into the secondary. Boom, right at the knees. Dale Carter comes up, the junior college transfer, hits him. The free safety making the tackles on third down. That's what you like as a quarterback and offense.
Joseph, 44 yards and 12 carries. Pass is complete to Greg Taylor. Waltzes his way down close to the 15-yard line. Good for 13 yards.
There you see the ball in and out of his hands. Gets it to Taylor. Taylor's going to make somebody miss. That's what gets the extra yard. That's what Tennessee was doing well in the first half. Not missing tackles in the secondary. 13 yards is a lot of yards at that end of the field.
Tennessee with a player injured. And I would say from the way he is padding that, it looks more like maybe a cramp than it does a pull muscle, doesn't
it? Hamstring or whatever. There's no doubt that he's stretching him out a little bit. I think it's Lincoln, isn't it, Jeremy Lincoln?
I think so, but we don't see the numbers, so we'll just wait until we do get a shot. 11:20 left to play, third period. Tennessee 19-3, and Auburn trying to come out of the locker room and send a message to the Orange from Knoxville. Yep, that's who it is, Jeremy Lincoln, the junior from Toledo, Ohio.
That's one you can file away as an offensive coordinator and say, if he comes back in the game, let's test a guy like that deep, because if he starts sprinting out there, he could pop that thing again.
Well, NASCAR racing tomorrow here on ESPN. It's the Winston Cup, Tyson Holly Farms 400 at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. That is tomorrow. On tape. Straight up the middle, they go with Tony Richardson, and the freshman is down to the 10-yard line. First down, Auburn Tigers.
The freshman says, come on, guys, I'll lead you. Come on, fans, where are you? Let's get in it. Don't give up on us. A lot of time. They put it in the end zone here. It's going to be a good football game.
They have spotted it just outside the 10, so it is not first and goal. Auburn can pick up a first down without scoring. Williams darts it to the right, at the five, and is down to the four.
That's it. Get him going, Pat. You said there was plenty of this talking in the locker room. Here it is, a little counteraction. Ed King, the All-American, leading it, coming around right at you in the living room right here. Bounces outside. Williams has provided him some speed to get to the outside. Been a big factor in this game so far. Joseph honks it up in there inside, but Williams can get outside that defense.
Richardson and Danley. The guys in the eye, it's Richardson hit at the line of scrimmage, and he is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Dwayne Dotson, number 33, steps up to make the initial contact. Dotson is the man who was subbing for Sean Walker, who was ejected from the ballgame.
And he's been all over the field. I mean, he's just filled in. We've seen him filling on the short yardage plays. He's been in the backfield. He's been running. He beat King a couple times when King was pulled around. He's played good football. But to lose your starter on the first kickoff is tough.
Tennessee defense has allowed no touchdowns in the last 10 quarters of play. Joseph, nothing there. Mark Moore was the first man to hit him. You see 74. Also Dwayne Dotson.
I think Dwayne Dotson filled in there also. Moore defeated the block, but Dotson scraped in again. He's been playing tried to spread them out to the wide side of the field and then run where that linebacker vacated with the two wide receivers, but they slanted right into it, the defensive set for Tennessee.
Third down. Auburn needs about 4 yards for the first down. Fourth down, I beg your pardon. Fourth down. Pass incomplete. He wanted Baxter.
I think what you're going to see here is Chuck Smith
Lance Nelson.
Unblocked. It's Casey Rogers.
No. Lance Nelson.
Lance
putting
Nelson,
the pressure.
You're right, puts it on him. There's nothing he can do but throw the ball.
Of course, this is 100 years of volunteers, 100 year of college football at Tennessee. Those still photos that you were watching as the volunteers keep it on the ground after stopping Auburn and bring it out to the 10-yard line with Amsler.
They're in their goal line offense, the same one they pushed it in from the five after the turnover. They're going to try to create some room, at least enough to punt the ball, but the first down, biggest first down, coming out of your own zone, it really helps the offense.
Amsler, and he is very close to the Tennessee first down out at the 15-yard line. In fact, from where they have marked it, it would appear that he has it. Dennis Wallace came up to make the hit on him. Now time has been called to bring in the chains.
Same play both times, running behind Big McCray. Tilt the backfield that way. Two plays, a first down from right there. That's not a good sign for the Auburn defense. It was tipped off. They knew where they were going to run, and they just powered it out of there.
Well, Auburn took the ball in their first possession in the second half with the punt and had the ball at their own 40, drove it right down the field, and then on fourth down, couldn't connect. Guarding the football, boy does he take a hit. Hangs on to the football as Darrell Crawford came up and checked his number very closely. Also Pierce. And for Tennessee, it's going to be a second down and long, about 8.5.
Watch Crawford sell out, jump over the pile and hit him with the shoulders. Puts the helmet and shoulder pads in midair, jumps over the blocker. That's the only way he could get close to him because there's a pile in front of him. Wow. What a play.
With the short pitch, good heavens, what another hit by Auburn. That's Dennis Wallace, the strong safety, a senior from Carrollton, Georgia, number 30, who came up and just tattooed him.
They watch it this time. They pitch it a little bit wider, so this time the free safety's the guy that has to fill. Yes, face right on the football. Just how they teach it. Get up. Yes, sir. Goal line defense against goal line offense there.
Tennessee with two wide receivers to the right on the third down and 8. Kelly, and he just throws that one away. He had blue all around him, and Tennessee will have to punt the football.
Reggie Barlow's going to put the pressure on him this time. It's a play-action pass, but he's got nobody open. He does a smart thing, throws it to the coach on the sideline. That's what he has to do. The junior comes through and let him punt the ball. A successful series for Tennessee. They get the big stop, and they make a first down.
Joey Chapman, his first effort tonight, good for 42 yards. Shane Washington is the deep man. This is not a very good punt, but Washington let it bounce and now will not get a return out of it. So Chapman takes the punt that was end over end and turns it into something pretty decent. We'll take a timeout. Tennessee by 16. Brand, quite a surprising story so far by the margin. Not that the Volunteers would be a surprise to win, but by leading by 16. White deep over the middle, tipped and almost intercepted. And I'll tell you, Dale Carter was was there. Let's go to Tim Brando.
Ron, how about those other Tigers against the Aggies of Texas A&M? Defense in the kicking game many times will win in the SEC. Watch Mike Garrett block the punt, and the 11th-ranked Aggies are trailing because Pedro Suarez would follow with a field goal for LSU in the third quarter. It's 3-0. Now in the fourth quarter, in Tallahassee, Virginia Tech trailing by 4. Terrell Buckley, a 53-yard interception return.
Thanks, Tim. 19-3 our score. We're just under 6.5 to play third period. White, good protection this time. Let's it rip, and Pedro Cherry stepping out of bounds at the Tennessee 43. That might have been as good a ball as White has thrown tonight.
He let it rip to the sideline. He knew where he was going. There you see the secondary drops. Just an easy zone coverage. The quarterback comes in, the out route down to the bottom of the screen, and there he is throwing it right on the button to Cherry. Nice throw. He actually read it right that time, threw it on the timing, and that's when the guy throws the ball. Well, any of us throw the ball well when you know where you're going with it.
Yes, sir, they went after it. J.J. McCluskey came to the ballgame replacing Jeremy Lincoln, who went out either with the hamstring pull or with the cramp just a moment ago. So Auburn came back and tried him out since he's new in the ballgame. Williams belts it down, but he's inside the 35 to the 34. Very close to a first down. No, not from where they marked it. It's going to be short by a yard.
Here's the counter again. This time you see Baxter closed down. You see Selby closed down, and Williams pops out outside. He's got some room to run. He takes it north-south after he hits it up the field. He's been their best runner so far tonight.
Curtis Fields, number 23, is the one who hit him with a shoulder-high tackle. Once, gonna go long, and he is looking for Greg Taylor in the end zone. Touchdown. The pump fake, and the defensive back bit on it.
The receiver never really broke down, though. There was no reason for him to bite. Now they're going to go for two right here. It's 19-9. They'd like to get it within to 19-11, so an 8-point difference.
Overton in motion. White throws back into the middle for Overton. Incomplete.
Let's go back and take a look at the touchdown pass to Taylor. You'll see White, a little pump fake. Taylor actually never faked, though. He just ran a streak all the way, and watch this pass. No wobble on this one. Right to the corner of the end zone. Boom, right in stride. Perfect throw.
These people never thought
of CFA football, where Tennessee is taking on Auburn in a matchup between two of the oldest rivals in the Southeastern Conference. The Tennessee Volunteers with a record of 3 wins, no losses, and 1 tie, while Auburn is 2-0. Due to time constraints, we are moving ahead to further action in this game. Be sure to tune in to ESPN's College Game Day each Saturday at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Time for previews and features of upcoming. Number 3 against number 5, and right now number 5 is knocking on the door again. Tennessee leads 19-9. They have a 3rd and goal from the 3. Marker goes down, and I think you could see movement on the right side of the Tennessee line.
Right tackle moved. He just a little bit, he flinched. I think it was Patrick Lenore, number 65, that just kind of moved just a little bit prior. I think the point again, Ron, right in front of the student
section. Ball snapped and movement by an offensive lineman. Still third down.
They changed end zones at the end of the quarter, and now they're right in front of the student section. They might have had a play in that.
Kelly calls a Tennessee timeout. So we'll take a break with the Vols up by 10.
expert from an old friend.
Is brought to you by Thrifty Car Rental. Because it's your money. Call 1-800 for cars or your travel consultant. And by Delta Airlines. We love to fly and it shows. Part of the capacity house here in Auburn. The situation. It is third down and goal from the 7 for Tennessee. Kelly trying to call an audible. I don't know for the world if they can hear him. They run option, the pitch to Amsler, touchdown Tennessee.
Kelly made a great play there. The whole Auburn defense was shifted to his right when they tried to spread it out. He audible to the option to the left. He had the pitch man, pitched it out, and Amsler just runs over the free safety into the end zone. Great call by the quarterback. You don't always have to win the game throwing the ball.
Greg Burke to attempt the extra point and try to put Tennessee up 26-9. The Volunteers, an underdog coming into this ball game tonight, ranked number 5 in the nation against the number 3 team. Jason Julian, the holder. He splits it. Greg Amsler, 10 carries for 40 yards and 2 touchdowns. And he is the young man who scored for the Volunteers just a moment ago on the option play.
There you see the option on the right side of your screen right there. They're outnumbered. He pitches it off. And he just rolls into the end zone, going to run right over Wiley. Wiley's a great tackler, but Amsler's a little bit bigger than he's used to hitting down on that 2 or 3 yard line. Big play of that drive, though. Remember, they had him stopped on the blocked field goal, but you cannot hit the kicker. It's not like the punter when you can hit him if you block the ball. The kicker is protected, and he catches him right on the right foot. Tough break for Barlow. I mean, he's given her it all to kind of come across and make the block, but that is a penalty. Pat Dye was wrong. Even though it was tipped, it's still protecting the kicker. It's not like the punter.
26-9. Still an entire quarter to go with the exception of 5 seconds.
We talked to the coaching staff and said they're prepared to go with the no-huddle offense. And just for this situation, let's see if they break it out right now. They need to hurry up and score some points. Put Stan White under the gun and calling it at the line of scrimmage. They've got to get as many plays as they can in this short. They've only got 14 minutes left in the game.
Herbert Casey for the 15. Breaks it out. 35 to the 40, and he's out to the 44. Storyline in this one so far. Auburn penalty on a field goal block. Volunteers go on to score 10 turnover points for Tennessee. Amsler, 40 yards, 2 touchdowns, and White, 12 of 27, 168 yards, and 1 touchdown. Tries to cut it back to the left side. He'll have a couple of yards. Tim Brando, what is going on now?
Over in the Pac-10 in Tucson, Arizona rarely loses. Well, watch quarterback George Malulu on fourth down, trailing by 7 in the final drive. He's picked off by Ray Sanders. Now Cal would settle for a safety, and the final score 30-25. Very rarely does Dick Tomey lose at home, but it happened against Cal tonight. Back to Ron.
King, the All-American guard for Auburn, coming off the field. Whether it is a cramp or if he did injure his knee, we'll have to wait and see. Is he favoring that right leg?
Right leg for sure.
Incomplete as Joseph was about to have his head taken off by Lance Nelson.
Before Ed King was taken off right there, Auburn was hustling up to the line of scrimmage to go with a no-huddle offense. But it's 3rd and 7 now. I mean, they've got to take their time. This is a big first down, and it may already be the situation where they have to chance it on 4th down.
White
zings it to his tight end Baxter across the 45, and that's enough for the Tiger first down.
Here we go, at the line, at the line. Make the calls. Get everybody lined up. A couple calls, you call it out to your interior linemen, and you give the signals to your wide receivers.
White to the near sideline, has it complete to Wasden. Breaks it inside the 35, and he's to the 32. That is an Auburn first down after a gain of 11. Dave Thomas defensively for the Volunteers.
Clock stops. He has time now to get him get another play call. They got to push it in the end zone fast.
Tennessee having to hustle a player off the field. Mark Moore with the no huddle. Tennessee coming with a blitz. Quick pass, and he hits the hot receiver at the 26. That's 20, Herbert Casey.
Tennessee has had success with this bare look. They're going to put seven people up there now because of the wide out spread out. You can't pick them all up, so you have to get rid of the ball. Good job by Stan White.
White, incomplete. So that'll stop the clock. Tony Russell couldn't get up high enough for that one. First time that we've seen him tonight. Tony is a sophomore from Birmingham. He comes right out of the ball game, and number four, Dale Overton, will replace him.
A lot of people call this the smash route, the delay route. The receiver walks off just a little bit, 5 yards deep, and reads the zone coverage. If they come from the outside, he runs in. If they come from the inside, he stays out wide. It's like throwing almost a long handoff for the quarterback.
Third down and about four. Pressure up the middle, caught again by Baxter, the tight end, and that's another Auburn first down. There is a flag down deep in the secondary, way down at the 11-yard line. Did Tennessee have illegal participation? 12 men on the field. We'll see. I tell you, Auburn has been doing this so quickly, and Tennessee still has tried to make substitutions. Moore was killing himself just a moment ago at 275. It's kind of hard to sprint just to get off the field.
Had a substitution infraction. It had 12 men. When I'm trying to get off the field, penalty reduced at first down.
There you see Dave Thomas trying to get off the field. You know, if you get more rest staying in the play than running off that fast like that. Coach, leave me out there. It's too tiring to come out.
26-9, Tennessee. Hit in the backfield is Williams, and he will have a loss of 2 yards as Kerry Bailey, the junior from Morgantown, West Virginia, smells it out and drops him for nothing.
I think you may have seen one of the last running plays we're going to see from the Auburn offense tonight until they get real close.
Baxter in the lineup. White zings it complete to Taylor. Fumbles the ball, and it is recovered by Wasden. And where he recovered it, they pick up the first down.
Just like they drew that one up. Absolutely perfect pass to begin with. He was covered very well on a very dangerous throw. White put it right on the money. Watch him sing it out here. Guy tries to cut underneath it, puts it right on the fingertips. The big hit, and there it goes. Go, go get it. Get the first down. Shane Wasden
picks up the first down. It was Ernest Fields. That's the second fumble that he's caused.
Caused from behind, too.
Yep.
He's
mm-hmm.
staying with the play and hustling and coming and getting the big hit.
He's a junior from Milan, Texas. Tennessee, beg your pardon.
Here they come again.
Whistles and flags. As there was a certain amount of consternation on that offensive front by Auburn as Tennessee.
Oh, the ball was snapped. We had illegal movement of the ball by the center. It'll be first down.
Tennessee, as Gary had just said, was bringing 8 men to the line of scrimmage.
You know, there's some types of blitzes where you don't have to disguise it. When everybody's coming and you know you got them outnumbered and they spread the field out like that, there's not much way to disguise it. They're just going to come and they're saying, you're going to have to throw it quick, Stan.
White ball tipped and incomplete. Mark Moore got a hand on it. Now let's finish that important play on the last drive, because this is what it reads in the rule book. Rule 913A, Section 7. When a player other than one who blocks a scrimmage kick runs into or roughs the kicker or holder, it is a foul. 1990 NCAA rules, interpretations.
Well, we didn't have the right section, but we had the rule pretty close.
Section 7. Draw play. Joseph breaks off a tackle at the 10 and is down for the 8. Dale Carter caught him just below the knees and saved what could have been 6. About to hit 12 minutes left in the ball game. 14 carries, 51 yards for Joseph.
Here they come. Here comes the kitchen sink again.
Pressure is on. Pass is tipped and incomplete. Fields is the man who was all over White, and it was Carter who came within a breath of going about 94 yards for a touchdown.
Fields put the pressure, and he had to throw the ball, and then those defensive backs could just run at it. Look at, he's got nowhere to throw the ball. And Carter, if he gets a hold of that one, you're going to change the scoreboard. But as a quarterback, there's nothing else you can do. You got to throw the ball.
Von Weil with a field goal attempt. Ball will be placed down at the 15, so it's a 25-yarder. Blocked, and his kick is good. So Auburn comes down with a drive to pick up 3. Tennessee 26-12. Shot over out of Baton Rouge. Von Weil will kick it off for Auburn. A drive just over 3 minutes. This is Carter. Gets tattooed at the 15-yard line. Clarence Morton on the special teams. And now, what does Auburn have to do, and then what does Tennessee have to do?
Well, of course, Tennessee would like to grind it out and make some first downs behind that line. Auburn should benefit from all the substituting they've been doing through the first 3 quarters. They should be fresh right now. I don't think they have to gamble. It's still a 14-point game. They can get it close by just playing sound defense. Of course, you'll take the turnover, but let's just get a 3 and a punt and give it back to White. He's starting to throw the ball well.
Thompson stopped for nothing. By the way, after that kickoff return, Dale Carter went limping off the field. The trainers came all the way out to the hash mark to meet him. So for the next time that Tennessee goes on defense, we'll keep an eye, because he is the starting free safety and really is highly thought of. And now Thompson is shaken up. The trainers come out to meet him.
Throw. Tennessee realizes how important this possession is. They're going to throw the ball. They have a lot of faith in Kelly. He's not going to panic. He put it right on the money right there. He put it in the spot where Morgan could catch the ball, but he couldn't avoid the turnover. 3rd and 10. Auburn, play it nice sound, and let's make him punt the ball and see what happens.
Third down. And the Auburn crowd all standing, making noise. And he'll just run it, play it safe, and Kelly comes out of bounds at the 17. Larry Young ran him out of bounds. Auburn stands to get. Very good field position out of this.
Watch, you see him going out of bounds. Now watch the open player. Don't get the dumb penalty now. Good play. Good heads-up play right there. Making him punt the ball. Look, they're going to get the ball back at the 45-50-yard line. Plenty of time.
Washington at the 39. Looks for a crease. It's knocked ahead to the 50. Mark Adams on the special teams. So Auburn takes it over with good field position. We'll be right back. Jackson, Fred Edelstein. Tennessee 49. White rolls it, got it away way too late, and then was punished by Casey Rogers after he threw it way back at the 40.
Casey Rogers knows Stan White pretty well tonight. He's been in his face all night. White really didn't have anybody to throw to. Kind of waited until the last second, throws it. Welcome to the SEC. Threw it out of bounds, though. That's a safe place to go with it.
19 of 37, one interception, 211 yards, and one touchdown. And for Stan White, he has missed his last five passes. Draw to Joseph. Auburn will look at a third down at about six as Dotson comes from the middle, and also Mark Fletcher.
Going with no huddle, but again, at this point in the game with 10 minutes to go, it's four down territory. They got to go for it.
Incomplete. Dale Overton was the man he wanted. And he's limping a little bit, but Dale Carter is now back in the ballgame. Preston Warren had come in replacing him. Now Pat Dye, as he sends the punting team on, signals for a timeout. And now the officials will give it to them. 10 minutes, 13 seconds left in the ball game. Tennessee leading by 14 points over the third-ranked team in the nation. We're going to go away for a moment. We'll be right back. Auburn will go for it. They need just inside the 40. White's delivery is caught by Herbert Casey for the first down.
Obviously, that's a big play on fourth down. They went for it. They wanted a punt. Now they got new life. Four more downs. They're in the no huddle, calling plays. Take your time. You don't have to force it. Just make completions. Move the chains.
White's delivery intercepted by Tennessee. That's Hardy. Say incomplete. I beg your pardon. That was a linebacker who had dropped 12 yards off the ball.
What they're giving him is kind of a zone look, but then they're matching up in the zone, kind of pattern reading to figure it out. And this is what you can't do. You can't force the ball into the zone like this. He read zone. He didn't read the matchup zone like they're trying to play. Just throw the ball, pitch and catch. You don't have to gain 15, 18 yards. They're going to give you the short one. Take it.
Good for 16 yards.
This time he comes out a little moving pocket, puts a little touch on it, throws it over the defense to Overton. Get your feet in, get out of bounds. Very, very nice. Well, they put one in the end zone here. It's going to be real, real, real tough for the Tennessee team to just run the ball. They're going to have to put it in the air coming back also. It's a good call. He had him on the post corner move. He was open. White was holding. Watch it. Wasden on the bottom of your screen is going to fake to the post. And he comes back at him. He's got him beat. Just trips over his own feet. And that's a touchdown in the corner of the end zone. Right by the flag. Right where he threw it. It's a timing route. You've got to depend on your receiver not to trip on that type of play. You're throwing it.
That's
before
the kind
he breaks.
Of pass that the people sitting in the stands saying, wow, that was a pick.
Terrible throw.
Yeah. It would have been a perfect throw. You're right. He's 21 of 42, 237 yards. Complete to Taylor, and boy, does he get wrapped up by Hardy. Oh, my goodness.
Here you'll see it. He half rolls to it. This is an audible also. And Lance Nelson, I think number 90, is going to be in his face again. He's got a quick delivery. No, it's Chris Mims. I'm going to vote for new different colors for Tennessee's jerseys.
Complete. In inside the 9-yard line, and that is close. It may be a first down. Greg Taylor.
Very tough to see on those jerseys up here, but Stan White is finding the right ones, I'll tell you right now.
I asked Doug Dickey about it at halftime, and he said, this is the way Johnny Majors wanted the numbers, but we were not the first ones to question it because they're not outlined. See, there's not a dark border around them.
Well, you can tell which ones are white and which ones are blue. You really don't care as a quarterback, but as an announcer, you do. I'll tell you that.
Pressure coming from all directions. The ball is tipped and incomplete. Taylor came up with the football, but he said he did not make the catch.
Here you see it from behind. He misreads it again. There's a guy right in the middle of the field, and he almost gets the touchdown pass out of it.
You know, that's Dotson again.
Dotson, it's the scheme, though. You got to give credit to the defensive scheme because he's got Stan White off balance all night. He thinks he's got a guy wide open, and there's a linebacker standing right in the vision.
Pressure from the middle. White has the ball tipped at the line of scrimmage, and it looks like Hardy, who got a hand on it. And he had Herbert Casey open in the flat with the defender covering or coming on him strong.
Here you see it, they're all coming on him. He's got a guy to throw to here, but knocked it down. Watch Stan White, he's upset in the back. Hardy, nice play. Guy's 6'3", jumps, knocks it down. 46 attempts. That's not the type of record you like to set.
White, incomplete. Cherry is the guy that he wanted in the end zone.
There was some contact there, but the ball was not at all catchable. It was way behind the receiver, and there's nothing the defender could have done. In fact, the receiver kind of slowed down to cause the contact.
Well, so now, fourth down.
Here it is again. He turns, throws it, but as you can see, it's well behind the receiver, and that's not pass interference. Well, let's see if he can pull another rabbit out right now. I mean, he's got fourth and very tough yards right now. 9 yards from this end, 8 yards.
26-12, Tennessee by 14. Pitch to Joseph. He'll score. There is a flag down, and the penalty is against Auburn.
It's been the little things all night that's really caused Auburn to throw this game away. The little procedures, guys not lining up in the right spot.
That illegal shift, had two men moving at the same time. They fourth down again.
It was an audible call. Somebody didn't stop and get set. The guy in motion, somebody shifted after he made the audible, and that's what caused the play.
Fourth down. New line of scrimmage, the Tennessee 13. Caught and touchdown Overton.
Makes a great play, comes back, gets the ball. All McCleskey has to do is really make the tackle. Going for the interception is the mistake he made right here. He puts it up. It's going to be caught. Oh, yes. How sweet. Run for it. They're back in the ballgame. Seven down. Plenty of time. Still 8 minutes to go in this game. There's the sideline reaction. Pat, yes.
I'm not sure I've ever seen Pat Dye that excited. So, 8 minutes and 28 seconds left to play. It is a seven-point ball game.
There you see Dale Overton, a walk-on who earned a scholarship, and it was well worth it right there. Came back, reached for the ball. It was still on the one-yard line. If J.J. would have just made the tackle, he didn't need to intercept the ball. Just knock it down would have been enough. Pat Sullivan, the former Heisman Trophy winner, working with Stan White. Got 8.5 minutes. Everybody's going to tell him, calm down. We'll get the ball back. If our defense puts the stop, we have time to win this game.
Short kick is going to be taken at the 14-yard line by one of the blocking backs. Tackled as he crosses the 20-yard line. Mario Brunson took the kickoff. He's one of the blocking backs. Morton made the hit. And you can hardly hear yourself think here in Auburn, Alabama right now.
Well, this is when the offense has to prove it can win a game on the field. Can they run the ball in this type of circumstances? That's why everybody loves to have a running offense. So just for this circumstance.
Thompson will have a couple to the 25. Let's go to Tim Brando.
Ron, the last time Auburn lost a game at home, it was to Florida State. And tonight, Florida State had a tough time in Tallahassee with Virginia Tech. They get Miami next week, and Bobby Bowden will be going after win number 200 in his career. Miami, you ask, against Iowa. It's a third quarter score now. 31-21, the Hurricanes. Let's get back to your game there in Auburn.
Timmy, second down and eight. Thompson takes it right up into the middle, has one, maybe two. It will be third down Tennessee, and the Volunteers need to take the ball just across the 32-yard line to keep this drive alive.
This is the situation. There's a lot more emotion now on this Auburn defense, but they should be fresher. They've been resting their people. This is when it pays off in the fourth quarter. Tennessee will have to throw the ball.
They're making a couple of substitutions. Is Auburn, they better get off the field. They do. Kelly throws it complete, and he is going to have the first down. And we're talking about by inches. Quickest way to take a crowd out of a ball game is that right there. As Pickens, who has been silenced in the ball game, of course he was shaken up. But that is a first down Tennessee.
All right, get it back. It's just a first down. Auburn still plays solid defense right now. They've got to force Tennessee to throw the ball. If they can grind it out running the ball, the game is going to end.
A yard at most. Crawford 56 off the bottom of the stack, along with Cunningham and David Rocker. And they're going to say no gain on the play. They will spot it squarely at the 33-yard line.
They ran it right into a weak corner blitz that time into the sideline. Barlow was coming right off the corner position in a rolled up secondary. Eight-man front, tough to run the ball. Auburn's definitely gambling.
Kelly, incomplete. Von Reeves, the junior from Knoxville, was the guy the pass was aimed at the 35. That will stop the clock with 6:19 to play. And for Tennessee, a third down and 10.
Kelly had a guy open that time. It was a little too high of a throw, and it's very tough for those big guys, those big tight ends, to catch a ball like that.
Kelly's pass is tipped. Alex Thomas, number 24, and it is beginning to rain here in Auburn. Joey Chapman to punt for the Volunteers. Not a heavy rain. 40% chance is what we had for tonight, and this is a gorgeous kick. Wasley from the 22, and he has his feet taken out from under him at the 29. Well, let's look at the scoring summary in case you were not with us from the outset of the telecast tonight. Burke with a 35-yard field goal, Tennessee 3-0. Then Burke with a 32-yarder, Volunteers 6-0. 12-0 as Alvin Harper took an 82-yard pass from Kelly. Went for two, that failed. Greg Amsler with a 3-yard run, 19-0 Tennessee. Auburn got on the board. Von Weil with a field goal of 36 yards, 19-3, and we'll finish the recap in a moment as the Auburn Tigers back on offense. White gets it away. Baxter, his tight end, out close to the 40-yard line. Ernest Fields is the man who popped him.
Close enough for a first down, so they're going to wave off, wave in the chain, stop the clock. That's going to give White some time to talk to everybody. Keep them up at the line, though, Stan.
Well, let's go back to the scoring summary. Then Greg Taylor, the 34-yard pass from White, 19-9, as the two-point conversion failed. Amsler with a 7-yard run, and Tennessee went up by a margin of 26-9. Then 26-12 in the fourth, Von Weil with a 25-yard field goal. And just a moment ago, Dale Overton with the 13-yard pass from White, 26-19, and that's how we stand. Here are the numbers on White as you look at the rain falling in Auburn. 25 of 49, one interception, 277 yards, and two touchdowns. Tennessee bringing a lot of folks as the pass is caught by Taylor. Wrestled out of bounds, and he is close to another first down. Carter defensively.
He's a beautiful thrower. I mean, he just puts that ball. It comes in and out of his hand so fast you can barely see it. And he hits so many people when he's relaxed and throwing the ball on the run. That's the key to it. Those are quick breaking routes to the outside. When you've got a quarterback that can throw the ball so effectively against the blitz, it's tough to run that blitz.
5:37 left in the ball game. Tennessee leads by 7. I'll tell you how wrapped up the people are in this ball game. We haven't seen anybody go for even a raincoat, let alone an umbrella or anything else. They don't care if they get wet. White caught over the middle by Casey. Fletcher was trying to cover, but that was a perfect route and pass.
Herbert Casey, look at Singh. He puts it up in there. That ball isn't in the air long enough for the zone to react like that. He's got a rocket for an arm, and he's relaxed now. He's throwing the ball like we saw him throw it in practice.
You see Tennessee walking those linebackers up. Pass to the far sideline. That caught by Pedro Cherry.
Time to huddle them up. There's a lot of quarterbacks that like not to huddle up in this situation because it keeps the defense from substituting. Even though the clock stops, you like to keep your offense up there, make the guys they've got out there stay out there.
Blitz up the middle. White is going to be sacked. Back at the 38-yard line, and it is Hardy, Darrell Hardy from Cincinnati, Ohio. And now Auburn will call a timeout.
The situation right there is Joseph has to move up behind the center and get that block. When this quarterback is under the center, he has to get away as fast as he can and depend on that fullback to make the block. He's the one that's assigned to that linebacker. A lot of times you'll see the fullback cheat up because there's no chance for him to get him. From as deep as he is, he has to avoid the quarterback and then still try to make the block. And in that position, the quarterback has to understand the protection and give the fullback time to move up behind the guard so he can make his block.
Well, tomorrow, 1 o'clock Eastern time, Major League Baseball here on ESPN. Toronto at Boston. And Boston's right now 2 games up in that American League East. 7-5, they won today. 1 o'clock Eastern time tomorrow here on ESPN. Lots of orange here tonight with orange and blue, the colors of Auburn, orange, blue, and white, and of course the orange and white of the Tennessee Volunteers. Our situation, 5:06 left to play. The Volunteers on top by 7 points. The line of scrimmage is just outside the 37. That's an 11-yard loss on that blitz up the middle by Hardy. And for Auburn, they need the 24-yard line. White, possibly tip, and almost intercepted, and Hardy had his teammate knock it away from him.
Tennessee only rushed 3 people this time, and when you rush 3 people and can still get a hit on the quarterback, that's very tough because the quarterback is looking at 8 guys dropping back in that secondary. There's not a lot of people to throw to. Mims comes from the outside. Looked like the ball almost slipped out of his hand, to tell you the truth. And the secondary, you'll see the defensive backfield, Floyd Miley right there, kind of runs into him and to jar it loose from his own player. They 2 guys could intercept this ball. Like a fight note.
Fourth down, and Auburn will punt with 4:59 left to play. Pooch kick is going to bound inside the 10-yard line and will be downed at the 8. 29 yards on the kick. And for Tennessee, as you look at that scoreboard clock, they want a couple of first downs, and that will just about take care of business. Auburn has only 1 timeout left in the game. We will be picking the Visa players of the game, 1 from Tennessee and 1 from Auburn.
Well, here you got it. I mean, we've set it up, the trenches, the battle of the trenches, and now the Tennessee offensive line is going to have to create a first down.
Pulls the fullback, takes it across the 10 to the 11. Ricky Sutton, the left outside linebacker, along with the Cunningham, making the stop. You can look for Andy Kelly to keep an eye on the 25-second clock and run it all the way down to just about 0 before he snaps the football. Going to go long. Incomplete, knocked away at the 40. Corey Barlow was trying to match step for step with Harper.
Well, it's a play that would have worked, and it was a pretty well-thrown ball, but it was thrown too late. He had Harper open, and he could have had the touchdown, but look, he waited too long. Harper's too fast to wait that long. He had him full speed, and Harper had to slow down for the ball. He was well underthrown. The real reason is he just waited too long to let the ball go.
7 of 20 in the ball game, but in the second half, 1 of 9 for 5 yards for Kelly. Screen pass. Amsler caught behind the line of scrimmage. It will be fourth down, Tennessee.
Great play by Darryl Crawford that time. Read it, stayed with his man. They tried to set up the screen, and Auburn succeeded. They punted the ball, and they're going to get it back in great field position. Watch him slice through there and make the tackle. Big play by Crawford.
Joey Chapman, now his longest punt of the year is 74 yards. Washington can't cheat up too much or he'll get one over his head. Washington to the 42-yard line of Tennessee. 3:26 left in the ballgame. Don't forget tomorrow the NASCAR Winston Cup, Tyson Holly Farms 400, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Tomorrow night here on ESPN. Ron Franklin and Gary Danielson here in Auburn, Alabama. I'm not sure that anybody has been in their seat for about the last half hour anyway. 7-point ball game. Pressure coming up the middle again, and they hit the tight end in the vacated area, and Baxter to the 21-yard line.
They blitz. He read the hot receiver. He hit him on the run, and Baxter turned it up. No huddle again.
White ball tipped at the line of scrimmage, and a chance at an interception as Mark Moore got a hand on it. It was Kerry Bailey who went diving after it was tipped. You got to give Tennessee that front credit. How many tipped footballs have we seen tonight? I know it's four.
At least four, and they've been in his face on maybe 10 other throws that have either caused an incompletion or caused a couple interceptions also.
And you never know what was behind that in the secondary. That's when those guys come up and say, hey, thanks, you might have saved my life on that one. Joseph on the draw. First down, Auburn Tigers, just outside the 10. Officials are calling a timeout, with which both clubs are going to be extremely pleased with. We have 3:01 left in the ball game, but it gets a chance for substitutions and also to get a breather. Tennessee has been running players back and forth out of the field. First down, Auburn.
There you see Johnny counting out, making sure he's got 11 guys out there with all those substitutions. That does happen occasionally.
You know, and boy, your point is well taken. It sounds like a simple thing, but of all the things, that's of all the penalties right. You don't want right now.
And that's tough because you are substituting a lot of guys, and so the fans don't understand it, but it does get confusing out there.
Auburn lines up in a goal line offense. Darrell Williams will not turn the corner. He will be knocked down, and it is Darrell Hardy again. Some kind of game he has played tonight. Wow.
They have not been able to successfully run the ball when they bring their formations tight. The Tennessee defense is running sideline to sideline and been able to stop them. Their most effective weapon has been the draw on the running play or spread them out and pass the ball, and that's what they're going to do again.
Over the middle, almost intercepted, knocked out, and he wanted to go to Fred Baxter, his sophomore tight end again. Fletcher cutting in front, playing a little possum there.
Well, he's had so many throws over the middle when he's had guys wide open, and he hasn't been accounting for that free safety or middle linebacker that's freeing up. This is a great system that they're running, a great scheme. They're forcing everybody into the middle, and they're freeing up. Actually, that one could have been picked off. Baxter kind of knocks the ball down.
Tennessee coming on the blitz as they roll the pocket. Pass is underthrown. It will be fourth down. 10.5 yards to go. Auburn needs to go to the 1 yard line to get a first down. And the Tigers have a player shaken up at the 10.
I think it's Eddie Blake. The big 310-pound junior college transfer. It's that ankle that's been bothering him before. That right ankle.
Fourth down, Tennessee. Or fourth down, Auburn. And this is what it comes to. Tennessee leading by 7 points, 26-19, with 2 minutes exactly. Now the clock is whistled back in.
Last situation like this, they sit back in a zone and they got burned. Are they going to come at him? I think they'll just sit back. The indication is it's going to be a blitz.
Tennessee creeping up. Blitz is there. Pass is thrown. to try to tie it. Tennessee has come close to a couple of blocks tonight. With 1:56 left in the ball game, we are tied.
It doesn't necessarily mean that Auburn's playing for the tie. There's still plenty of time in this game, and he's throwing it over to Johnny Majors right now. He says, are you going to play for the tie? Are you going to run the ball, or are you going to gamble after we kick it off to you? There's still time for them to get a couple stops, or if Majors decides to throw, get an interception. Here it is. He's just throwing it up, hoping a prayer here. Again, they go for the interception, and that's what caused the touchdown. All they have to do is make the tackle.
Gary.
One more look at it. He grabs it from the highest point. All-out blitz. They tried it both ways. You really can't blame the defensive call that way. One time it was his own. There you see the sideline reaction. So two fourth down plays for touchdowns.
You talk about the wisdom of a veteran coach in Johnny Majors. Tennessee did not rush that time to avoid getting a roughing the kicker again, which might have given Auburn an opportunity from a yard and a half away to go for two to go in front.
And on top of that, they don't want to fake to lose the game when they've got an all-out rush on also. But both reasons, it was the correct move to just lay back. It's going to be interesting to see what Tennessee does when they get the ball back.
Into his own man, and he is out to the 23. Now Tennessee has two timeouts left. Auburn one.
The important call is that Auburn only has one. If they want to get the ball back, they've got to stop them and hope Tennessee throws the ball to stop the clock. See, I don't think he's just playing for the tie right there. I think he has just as good a chance of winning this game by playing defense right now and throwing it back on the Tennessee offense, saying, do you want to make the tie?
Both coaches told us in situations where the tie or go for two this early in the SEC season, they would go for one to tie. But in this situation, both still have a chance to win it. Thompson bounces from behind his offensive lineman in the tackle and is out close to the 30. Corey Barlow defensively. Keep an eye on that clock. Is Thompson very slow in getting up?
Kelly has to be extremely careful with the ball. A turnover down here could be the ball game.
Thompson is slow in going off. He was shaken up. They're getting a replacement in Amsler. And Tennessee using up some very valuable time. Kelly will run for it and have the first down plus about eight. Wiley from the secondary. Kelly didn't want to take a chance of throwing a pass that might be a bad one, and he picks up plus yardage.
Now he's in the position on the field when he can throw the ball past the 50-yard line. A lot more confidence.
Zips it incomplete at the 48-yard line. You see Morgan staying on one knee for a second just for that extra gasp of oxygen.
The aiming point all the time for a quarterback is try to get it to the other team's 30-yard line. That's the range where you have a chance to win the game. That's really a couple passes away. You just don't want to make the big mistake. You've got still got three downs, two downs, and punt the ball whatever way you want to do it if it's short. But just take your time, pitch and catch, move the chains.
The 45-yard line, and I'll tell you what, Pickens was on his knees. He had fallen.
One more completion like that, and they're in field goal range, but that was the only place it could have been thrown.
That is only his second pass completion of the second half. Over the middle, caught with a one-hand grab behind him is Harper. There is a flag down.
What a
two
catch.
Flags are down. And boy, the only thing you could surmise there is the possibility of a face mask from it being thrown as quickly and down the field at the point of contact. Unless it's a late hit.
Dead ball foul, late hit, and blue. First down, 15 yards.
Wow.
Behind the back with the hit.
What a catch.
And there it is right there.
See, there was a ball that was being juggled right there, and he was coming in to look for the free ball. Kind of a cheap call, but it's going to happen in that situation. The referee didn't see the ball getting bobbled, and now Tennessee's in the running area. They're just going to run the ball now and kick the field goal.
Clock is running. 29 down to 28. Tennessee straight ahead with the run. Tony Thompson. And Tennessee will call a timeout with 20 seconds left in the ballgame.
I'll tell you what I like to do here, Ron. I like to kick the field goal even early, because if you get a bobbled snap or the holder mishelp, you can call timeout and you get another try for it. If you use your timeout on second to after this next running play, then you're in trouble, because if you bobble the snap, you can never kill the clock again and get two tries. So I wouldn't even be surprised if they kick the field goal right now and then they have time to call a timeout if something goes wrong. The angle isn't great, I admit that, but boy, it'd be nice to have two tries in case something goes wrong on the snap. That was one of the best catches. I mean, that ball was thrown behind and he just reached
behind his body and made the reception. There's the scoring. Auburn coming back with 16 points in the fourth quarter, but the Tennessee Volunteers, and you said it, to take care of business, and you were anxious to see what they would do with the football. Here they are at the 14-yard line.
Well, I bet it's a run to the right.
He takes it to the middle of the field and goes to his knee with 15 seconds left, and Tennessee has just called their final timeout of the ballgame. Don't forget, coming up next, UCLA at Washington State. Greg Burke is a senior from Key Biscayne, 6'1", 190 pounds. You saw Andy Kelly roll to his right, take it just to the middle of the field, and go down on one knee so that the ball will be squarely resting there.
Can't ask for anything better. It's better than kicking from the 30 where I was aiming for. They got it down there, and it's just it's not going to be a distance. Is it going to be a problem? 34 yards. He just has to keep it straight.
You could see Johnny Majors walking down the sideline as far as he could go within the restraining lines, and to his offensive group that is up front, saying, with the arms folded in front, make sure you do a good job of blocking.
And also make sure you don't get a penalty. We don't want to grab anybody right now. Let's just block it by the rules and take what happens.
This attempt will be 34 yards. Long enough, and no good. And now there is a marker at the 23 that probably is for the Auburn celebration. Greg Burke was 14 of 16 in 1989. The flag will be for the celebration against Auburn. There are 11 ticks left on that clock.
After the play was over, we had too many men on the field off the bench, so their delay of game, 5-yard penalty, the first down.
Let's not have any fun. I mean, the guys ran out there. It's the biggest game of the year. They're hugging each other, so we're going to call a flag on that one. That's searching for a penalty right there.
From the 15-yard line. And Auburn is going to run it out. They are not going to take a chance. They have the safety valve standing at the 3, and White will go down on one knee. Thank you. Here's your final. Tennessee 26 and Auburn 26. And two longtime friends in Pat Dye and Johnny Majors come out to shake hands. Both had said yesterday that being the first or this early in the conference season, that given the opportunity, that they would not risk a loss, that they would go for a tie. And Pat Dye did not take a chance on having a fumble or a pass interception. He runs out the clock. So tonight's Visa players of the game are from the University of Tennessee, quarterback Andy Kelly, and from Auburn University, quarterback Stan White. And as part of their continuing effort to further the development of amateur athletics, Visa is proud to donate $1,000 to each of these universities and $1,000 to the U.S. Olympic team on behalf of these athletes. I'd like to give one other kudos that probably should go out. If he didn't get MVP, Darrell Hardy certainly deserves a world of credit. Very quickly, your thoughts.
My first SEC game was about as exciting as it could get. It was a lot of fun. Both quarterbacks started slow but came through in the end.
So, Auburn, in a come from behind, winds up in a tie with Tennessee at 26 apiece.